What's up, everyone? We're just going to go over a couple different styles of exercising that you might see in your program, you might not. So if you're in a purely like muscle building program, you're not really going to see this. But if you're in a body recomposition, you're probably going to see this. And if you're in a weight loss or fat loss program, you're definitely going to be seeing these, because these are really good at not only helping you shed extra calories and extra weight, but they also will increase your conditioning and your cardiovascular health. So these are really, really good. So let's talk about these. These are all forms of high intensity interval training, which is HIIT, right? You probably hear that a lot. High intensity interval training, which simply means that you're gonna have a given exercise or bout of exercise that's really, really tough, and then some rest in between is essentially what it ends up being. These are really good for, these type of exercises are really good because they compress the amount of time that you need to do cardio. And what they do is they help you burn more calories throughout the day by creating a huge and massive oxygen debt. That's why they really work. So the first one, simple circuits. Think of this as like a big like superset with 3 to 4 different exercises where you're gonna be doing a given number of reps between each one, and then, you know, and then cycling to the next one. So a simple circuit, say, is, you know, back squats to bent over rows to bench press to, you know, walking lunges, right? You'll have 10 reps at each, and then you'll have a rest interval in between. So you'll do 10 reps at back squat, 10 reps at the bent over row, 10 reps at the bench press, and then 10 reps at the walking lunge. And you'll go through that as many rounds or as much time as it is for you. So it can be interval, it can be on rounds, but that is essentially what a circuit is. Those are good for total body conditioning and things like that, helping get some of that, you know, extra aided fat loss. The next one is Tabata, right? A typical Tabata is 4 minutes of like pedal to the metal, and I'm talking like 110% effort. You are leaving everything out on the table, because again, it's only 4 minutes. So it's 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. Typically you can do 1 to 2 different exercises. So think of like burpees to med ball slam. So if you had a burpees and med ball slam Tabata, it would be 20 seconds of burpees, as many as you can get, and then a quick 10 second break before moving straight into as many med ball slams as you can for 20 seconds. And you'd go through that cycle until the 4 minutes is up. Now we can extend these Tabatas a little bit more and do like 2 sets of them. So you have like an 8 minute or a 12 minute, but you definitely have some rest in between. It just depends on where you are and how advanced you are. And then over here, we have an EMOM. This is made popular by CrossFit, but they really do have some benefits. And we can do EMOMs in a more typical HIIT style setting, or you can actually do them in a strength style setting too, but you guys probably won't be seeing a whole lot of that. If you have questions, we can chat about it. So EMOM simply stands for every minute on the minute. So we'll just go back to two simple exercises, right? So you have bench press and squats, and it's an EMOM of 5 reps of bench press and 7 reps of back squat. So what this means is you'd have a set time. So say it'd be a 10 minute EMOM. When the clock says go, you would do 5 reps at bench press, and then however long that takes you, say it takes you 10 seconds to do that, you'd have the remaining 50 seconds before the start of the next minute before you moved on to the back squat and you performed the back squats, and you'd cycle through that. So it's however long the exercise actually takes you, you get the remainder of that minute to rest. And the next one over here is AMRAP. So this simply means as many reps or rounds as possible. So you can have AMRAPs that are 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes long. And a number of exercises, right? You can have 3, 4, 5, 6 exercises in there, and you will have a prescribed amount of reps for each exercise. So if it was bench, squat, push-ups, right? It'd be 10, 10, 10. You would just go through that, those 10 reps of each of those, as many times as you can in the time that you have. So if it was a 10 minute EMOM, or sorry, 10 minute AMRAP, You would do those three exercises and try to rack up as many rounds as possible and record the rounds. It's important that you record the rounds because what that does is it gives us a level of your conditioning and your fitness so that if we need to make changes to it as well. It's a really great way to get, like, test yourself and to challenge yourself and to see how you're progressing. So just wanted to clarify what those are. If you see those in your program, now you know what they are. If you have any additional questions, please feel free to reach out.